Hello everyone, welcome back to Bosco Campus Vision. So in today's session, we'll be dealing with visual media as well as new or digital media. So what do you mean by visual media? From the term itself, we can conclude that it is something that includes our eyesight, our vision, right? See, visual media in part or whole relies on eyesight. So visual media, it is completely or partially, it relies on our eyesight. It conveys ideas and information in forms that can be seen. Visual media is a broad spectrum that includes signs, typography, drawing, graphic design, illustration, industrial design, advertising, animation, color, and electronic resources. In short, anything that can be seen, it is included inside the broad spectrum of visual media. The next point. Visual media helps readers clarify and comprehend information because they are able to develop their own perception of the content and avoid misinterpretation. So comparing to a print media, visual media, it gives more light into the topic. So visual media helps the readers clarify and understand the information or messages more accurately, and it helps them to reduce misinterpretation. So one of the most obvious examples of visual media is definitely television. So let's have a quick look at television. We've already dealt with the strengths and limitations and all of television in the previous session. So we'll make this session quick. So television, it is one of the most influential media today. Television is considered as one of the most influential media today. The advantage that this medium enjoys over the traditional media like newspaper and radio is that it is audio-visual. So television, it involves two of our sensory organs, and that is audio as well as visual. So that is another feature of television. Next point. With TV, it is possible to see and hear about events happening in far-off places, even while one remains within the four walls of one's home. This ability of TV to enter homes and thus lives makes it a personal medium. So television, just like a radio, is considered as a personal medium because it has the ability to influence people, and it is considered as a vital part of our life. So it is considered as a personal medium, right? Next point. It is a powerful medium that has the power to influence and affect human lives. And television is a window of the world for news and information. Television, it is not just an object of entertainment, but in these days it is considered as an object of infotainment. It provides both information as well as entertainment. So it is considered as a window of the world. Next point. It provides needed escape and relaxation. It is one of the greatest strengths of television. It provides needed escape and relaxation for people. And that is all about visual media. Moving on, we have new media or digital media. What do you mean by new media or digital media? Let's have a look. New media are forms of media that are computational and rely on computers for redistribution. Some examples of new media include computer animations, computer games, websites, electronic books, electronic newspaper, etc. So these are the examples of new media. Now, new media does not include analog broadcast television programs, feature films, magazines or books, unless they contain technologies that enable digital generative or interactive processes. So for something to be considered as new media or digital media, it has to be interactive. For example, consider the platforms like Facebook or Twitter, as they also contain space. It also contains the comment section so that the people can interact. So it is considered as new media or a digital media. The next point. Digital media has global reach and allows instant access and quick reproduction. Yes, it is connectable, right? The next one. The striking features of new media are interactivity, hypertext, and virtuality. So these three qualities, interactivity, hypertext, and virtuality, they make new media or digital media unique. Interactivity simply means the ability to involve the audience. And we can say that compared to other media forms, new media has the most evolved feedback system in place. Digital media offer us a significant increase in our opportunity to manipulate and intervene in media. So that is interactivity. Next one is hypertext. The term hypertext has come to describe a text which provides a network of links to other texts that are outside, above, and beyond itself. So another feature of new media or digital media is its hypertextuality, and it simply means that it has the ability to connect or link to other information or messages. With a simple click, we can get multiple information regarding even a single subject. So that is hypertextuality, and it also provides virtuality. Along with these qualities or traits, new or digital media also possess other qualities like immediacy. It provides provides information very quickly. Like we have 3G and 4G technologies that enable us to be quick with our searchings. The next quality is its universality. Web journalism, it is a global media right now. So universality is also another striking feature. And with this, we come to the end of this session. Today, we have discussed about visual media and new or digital media. As assignment, answer these two questions. The first one, define visual media and state some examples. The second one, define new or digital media. Thank you and have a nice day.